Joy Olson, Blockbuster Fundraising. July, it's July. It's hard to believe. Well, you know, summer is a quiet time for many nonprofit organizations. Donors are on vacation, students are out of the classroom, and many staff members take well-deserved time away from the office. However, summer is also an important time to plan for the fall, when development activities quickly swing into full gear. When fall rolls around, you're going to be really glad that you took advantage of the summertime lull for some preparation. Now, here are 5 tips for making the most of summertime to get ahead. Tip number 1, hey, develop a summer calendar and stick to it. At the beginning of summer, develop a fundraising calendar that takes you through fall. Maintaining a calendar is a very important planning piece for your determining and working against deadlines. Include internal meetings with development staff as well as external meetings and events with key leadership and prospective donors. Make sure that everyone in the development office receives a copy. It may even be helpful to color code your calendar events, like blue for board activities, red for cultivation events, yellow for internal development meetings, and so on, so that everyone in the office is aware of upcoming events and can plan their schedules accordingly. Developing your calendar is the first step. Guess what the second step is? The second step is working on it. Organize your time so that you are able to meet deadlines and prepare necessary develop materials before fundraising activities pick up after Labor Day. Tip number 2, do your prospect research during this downtime. Prospect research is key to cultivating and soliciting donors, but it can take a significant amount of time. The summertime is a great opportunity to conduct prospect research, whether this is for incoming parents, like at school, new donors to your annual fund, or current donors whom you would like to approach for a special campaign gift. It is helpful to develop a research profile for each of your donors that includes, but is not limited to, the donor's relationship with your organization, professional background, education, board affiliations, and notable philanthropic contributions. This information will enable your organization to better understand its prospective supporters. Tip number 3, revisit your pipeline when things are slow. While school is closed or your major donors are out of the office, use the downtime to revisit your donor pipeline and refine your personal cultivation plans. Make sure that your pipeline is up to date and includes donors' most recent activity, next steps, and current target asks. This will help you prepare for any upcoming meetings and ensure that the donor moves smoothly from cultivation to briefing to solicitation. Hey, it's easy to put off updating your donor pipeline, but it is important to allocate 15 to 20 minutes at the end of each business day to update your donor activity. If you have updates for 2 donors or 10, get into the habit of inputting them into your pipeline. Updating your pipeline is going to ensure that you are prepared when it is time to conduct a briefing or solicitation meeting. Tip number 4, prepare marketing materials during these quiet periods. Marketing materials are such important tools for sharing your organization's mission and highlighting key programs that you feel warrant financial support. However, Developing these materials, especially if your organization works with a professional design or creative firm, can take time. You know that. So spend some time over the summer revamping the language and design for your current appeals. Whether it's your annual fund appeal, your year-end appeal, or case for support for a capital campaign. By the time fall arrives, try and have these materials ready to send to prospective donors. Tip number 5, plan cultivation events for fall right now, because September and October are busy months for fundraising, and you don't want to begin planning your events when you should be focusing on building personal relationships with your donors. Therefore, plan your cultivation events early. Brainstorm ideas for effective fundraising events and use the time that you have over the summer to check logistics off of your to-do list. Secure venue, check. Confirm catering, check. Develop guest list, check. This way, once the event is just a few weeks away, your main responsibility will be managing the guest list. Well, do you need a few more ideas for the lazy days of summer? Well, these come from Razoo, and we all know that come summertime, fundraising tends to slow down for many nonprofits organizations because you're taking a break between your spring auction or gala and bracing for the holiday and the end of the year season to come in the fall. It's not worth trying out summer fundraising, is it? Razoo says, well, glad you ask. And yes, it absolutely is worth it. So if you're looking to infuse some creativity into your more traditional fundraising methods or close the gap in this year's annual budget, you're at the right place. Summer fundraising is a largely untapped opportunity, and you can make sure to keep the fundraising fun and your other initiatives going throughout the rest of the year if you take this opportunity to raise even more funds for your mission this summer. So Razoo says that they've pulled together the best ways that you can make the most of your summer fundraising plans. They suggest this: join an existing community event. Chances are that your community, city, or state has all kinds of fun events planned for the summer. And that's no wonder. The weather is nice, the kids are off from school, the families are always looking for fun events to get outside and get active during the summer. So take advantage of these existing events in your community, whether it's a 5K, a marathon, or a bike race. Let the event organizers focus on the logistics of running the event and gathering the permits, and you just focus on getting a few supporters to participate in the race to raise funds for your nonprofit. Sounds easy, right? Well, this is a great summer idea, and you might want to get in there and check out your city or community or county's calendar right now. Because when you have nothing that you've got to manage for this event, you can focus on helping your fundraisers with tools and ideas for success. And before long, you'll develop a whole new source of funding with little time investment from you or your staff. Hey, this is a perfect time to get a leg up on the competition. Other nonprofits may tend to slow down their fundraising appeals over the summer, but use this season to your advantage. During the holiday season, by contrast, your supporters are getting emails from tons of nonprofits, which may mean your message and your ask are left competing against all the others in their inbox. With less competition in the summer, right now, your message will stand out, leading not only to more donations, but also, hopefully, a better understanding of the critical impact your nonprofit has on your community. Even better, Use this extra advantage to get your supporters to start a fundraiser on your behalf. You can do that with lots of different software out there. You can make it easy for them by creating a fundraiser template, so all they have to do is join the effort and spread the word. What else can you do during the summer months? Hey, build your donor base with new names. Summer may be a slower time for fundraising, but it comes right before the busiest time of the year for giving. So instead of just thinking of summer as a planning time for fundraising, think of it as a prospecting time to build out a whole new list of names and emails that you can cultivate when the busy giving season comes back round. This is a great time to grow your donor pool with new contacts. And you are going to be tapping into personal networks and introducing family and friends that have never given to your organization. This is a great time. And their first step is bringing new donors into the fold through their campaign. And then you have a few critical months to engage and cultivate these new donors so they can make their second gift to your organization once the holiday season is here, and it'll roll around soon. Hey, good idea for summer? Involve your staff and board in summer fundraising. You don't always have to look outside of your organization to find good opportunities to amplify your fundraising. Use the extra summer downtime and encourage your staff and encourage your board to get involved in a new way through online fundraising. You can create a fun competition between staff members or pit the staff against the board to see who can raise more funds for your cause. Encourage your staff to raise funds by adding in fun incentives, like an extra day for getting off, competition. Make it fun and easy with an internal event like a barbecue or a picnic. Not only will you raise funds for your cause, but you'll create a new opportunity for staff and board engagement to build morale. And summertime can be a great time to engage a local business. Consider how you can involve local businesses as partners in a summer team fundraising campaign. Think outside the box. There are all kinds of ways that businesses can participate and give back. They can encourage their employees to participate as volunteers or participants in your event. Businesses can offer prizes like gift cards or merchandise for top fundraisers in your campaign. They could even offer a matching incentive if your fundraisers can raise a certain amount. So this is like a really good summer idea for these online peer-to-peer fundraising. And the bonus here is you can get your whole staff engaged, and it will form a stronger partnership that your nonprofit can build on throughout the entire year. Summertime is a great time to discover new content. Looking beyond the dollars and the donors that will come in, you can take this time to really engage your supporters to start their own fundraisers on behalf of your nonprofit. Or you can create an opportunity for these supporters to tell you a personal story about the impact of your organization. So whether they've served as a volunteer or a staff member or have received the benefits of your work directly or indirectly, they will have a unique and personal story that showcases the impact of your mission. And hey, these stories are critical to enhancing your fundraising efforts and communicating your impact to your supporters. So this is a great time to get content like that together, a whole new bank of photos and stories to showcase your impact throughout the year. So take advantage of this time, because summer fundraising, what that means is right around the corner is fall fundraising. So you really want to create momentum and excitement about what you're doing and get things in order right now. Hey, Joy Olson here, Blockbuster Fundraising. Hope that you're having a great summer, and we look forward to seeing you every Friday. No, what am I saying? Every Tuesday at 1 p.m. live. And we have more information at joyolsongroup.com, blockbusterfundraising.com. We love our Instagram IGTV channel, so catch us there. And in the meantime, we hope that you are raising the kind of money that not only funds your work, but that is actually transforming your organization's potential and reach. That's our goal. Thanks for having been here today. Bye-bye.